this evening, so Cheryl, me, David, and Cheryl were trying to figure out how to best do this. We just figured we'd make time up to 5 minutes for everybody to speak. I said, we'll give it 5 minutes. I know they'll go over, but we'll give them, I'll put the timer away. All right, and let's be respectful of everyone's time. And I'm going to start with Councilor Hesmahan. We'll start in Ward 3 with Councilor Hesmahan. If you want to come on up for your farewell speech, let's hear it for Councilor Hesmahan. My esteemed colleagues in government and members of the public, in my work I've tried to draw inspiration from the life of Senator Paul Douglas, a fellow Unitarian who set an admirable example for honesty and integrity in public service. As a member of the Chicago City Council, he was known as an idealist and a reformer. When World War II broke out, he joined the Marines at the age of 50 and became a war hero. In his later years in the U.S. Senate, he was renowned for fighting pork barrel spending, as a tireless advocate for civil rights, and as an ardent environmentalist who helped save miles of pristine Lake Michigan shoreline through the creation of the Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore. Of his life in public service, he once said, "In my early years, I wanted to save the world. In my middle years, I would have been content to save the country. Now, I just want to save the dunes." From the time I first joined the Board of Aldermen in 2003, my passion, and some would say my obsession, has been to promote housing affordability and address income inequality in Newton. While we have improved some affordable housing projects in the last 10 years, we have barely moved the needle toward reaching the 10% minimum threshold under the state affordable housing law. Indeed, in my opinion, far too much time and resources have been wasted fighting affordable housing rather than promoting it. While Newton has increasingly become a gated city where money is the key to get in, and far too many people are content to allow the gate to close and lock behind them. And even in this holiday season, many homeless families are living in motels, and many other families will become homeless through eviction and foreclosure. Right here, right now, in one of the wealthiest states in the nation. We can and we must do better. I came here 14 years ago with high hopes for closing the widening gap between median household income and housing costs in Newton. After I was here a while and discovered how challenging it can be to make even incremental progress towards that goal, I would have been content just to help working families keep pace with the rising cost of housing. In this last term, I just wanted to save the accessory apartments, to allow seniors across the city to be able to afford to stay in their homes and offer millennials affordable opportunities to live and work in Newton. But there is hope. There is always hope. The city has a housing strategy. It's a good strategy. And I urge all of you who will continue to serve to support it and to pass comprehensive zoning reform that will promote housing affordability and assure racial, ethnic, and economic diversity right here in Newton. You can do it, and you should. Do it for homeless families and individuals who need a place to live. Do it for low to moderate income households and the rapidly growing number of middle income families who can no longer afford to live here. Do it for our children and our children's children. It has been my honor and privilege to serve this great city for the past 14 years. Despite working many late nights and weekends and the many meetings and phone calls and emails, and often kept me away from my family and away from my day job. I have no regrets. Not even that time, in fact, particularly not that time, when I brought a leaf blower into the chamber and turned it on during the Board of Aldermen's deliberations on a proposed amendment to the noise ordinance. Say hello to my little friend. So in parting, I want to offer a little bit of unsolicited advice to the newly elected members of the City Council and to my colleagues who are returning, with a quote from Mark Twain. And of course it's a quote because that's how I roll. Always do the right thing. It will gratify some and astonish the rest. Thank you, and best wishes, and good luck to all of you.